this is a political trial. You're a political figure. You do incredible work as a human rights defender, as a human rights activist and grassroots activist. But really, it's about the politics in Hebron, and you're interfering in their plan to take over Hebron. And again, the part of Hebron that you are involved with, you know, the settlers are just, you know, they can't wait to get it. Number one, because it's so beautiful, it's so historic, it's historically significant, it's a strategic spot, and you're in the way. So what can people do? I mean, we have the petition up, people can sign the petition, but a lot of people are going to want to do more. I mean, keeping you or at least demonstrating support for you is crucially important because of you personally and also because of what you represent as a Palestinian and the Palestinian struggle. So what can people do other than just sign the petition? And again, I'll just say, I understand the petition is actually targeting the UN General Secretary, if I'm not mistaken, right?
Yes, and the EU representative. I want the people to know that Palestinians will not give up their rights. Me personally, I will not stop resisting the Israeli occupation. I think I was born to resist. I will never coexist with the Israeli occupation. I want them not to lose hope on the Palestinian cause, because I see many people think after Mr. 45, big damage to the Palestinian cause, that they think that we are losing. We are not losing, and we will never lose. We will keep fighting, resisting the Israeli occupation. And this is what I want them to do. I want them first to believe in themselves. And I want to thank them for what they are doing in their countries for Palestine and for the Palestinians, because they are doing it for a valid cause and for the history, and they are writing their names in the defender list. I want them to keep writing about Palestine and to be very creative about how to increase the cost of the Israeli occupation, increasing the cost economically, politically, even in their community, in their synagogues, so to keep increasing awareness, not to stop or give up about increasing the awareness about what is happening in Palestine and about the occupation, all of that, and to write to their lawmakers and to the stakeholders and to send their celebrities to us, to Palestine. I want my American friends, I met Bernie Sanders and he promised me that he will visit Palestine. I want Bernie Sanders, if I am in jail or not, to come and visit Hebron and see apartheid and talk about apartheid. This is one of the missions we should start working from now on, bring Bernie Sanders and other celebrities in the United States and to show them the reality of the occupation. I want people to write to the media, to observe the media, what the media is writing is very important because we don't exist in the mainstream media. So please keep writing to the editors and to the show organizers, all of them, to tell them that Palestinians should have a voice, to post the voices of the Palestinian people. Miko's your interview and your meeting tonight is great. So other meetings as this meeting with me, with many other Palestinian human rights defenders, will give us hope, and we feel that we are protected and we are not alone in the field. This is something very important. So some people think that protesting in the field or organizing an action with a small number doesn't make a difference. No, it makes difference to me, to Issa, to my people, that we exist and our cause is completely alive till now. So I want people to do all this kind of creative actions to make the occupation costly and to make the occupation really more expensive for the occupiers and for the supporter of the occupation. The settlers in Hebron collected a lot of money in the last 2-3 months from the United States. Hebron Fund got $1 million in few days to support the settlers. Target Hebron Fund, target anybody is giving money to the Israeli settlers in Hebron. Think about how to make them ashamed of giving their money to contribute to the restrictions on my life, to the occupation, to the apartheid, to the segregation and separation. And don't give us hope. Keep going. What are you doing? And thank you very much. What are you doing? We notice what are you doing. And it's not easy. It's hard. We are one, one partner to make the change. And they see it very close to happen because we have many people in the world supporting us. But it's about how to break the ice to make the occupation costly and more expensive.